going, Sam?
What's up, man?
What are we up to today?
We just got back from the studio. But we got a lot of progress done there, so the next time we get in there, we'll actually put it onto CD. Bam. They're going to be able to hear it. So we're really looking forward to that. So we'll actually put a release date on it.
When we did Remember Vegas, that was within the span of a day, and that was like 6 tracks back to back within the span of like a few hours. This EP is well more thought out. We really took our time with this one, and we didn't really put a restriction as far as writing. Like, if we felt like, okay, today we're going to write a new song, we did it, you know, and we jammed it, we demoed it out, and it wasn't like we stuck to a particular regime or anything like that. We just went with what felt right. And now we have like a pretty good plethora to choose from. So I think it's recorded more at our leisure now, as opposed to last time when, you know, we were on time constraint, or we were like, okay, we got to get this done, we got to get it out there, you know. There wasn't any rush on it, so I think that's what worked out in our favor this time around. You done?
Yeah.
That's the song?
I think it's just a taste of what's to come, because, I mean, don't get me wrong, what we've written is, well, honestly, the best that, you know, just my musicianship or what I'm, you know, just pouring out. But give it a little bit of time, you know. The more I'm writing, the more, you know, I'm maturing in my writing.
Really crazy to see where Remember Vegas kind of, you know, took those little personal inner demons that we had, and now it's formulating into like all of these new stories. And I mean, we're just really hitting our stride, I think, as what as writers, you know. We're starting to have a lot more fun with what is it.
Everything what's in you, not just what you play, metal, rock, folk, country, it doesn't matter. And then you venture on, you do other things like that. There's nothing wrong with that, because that, as a musician, that's going to give you a better appreciation for other music. Because I'm sorry, most people can agree too, like metal and stuff like that. That stuff didn't come around until those other bands, those earlier bands were here. And that's something that people forget. And, I mean, it goes for every musician has that one person, that their idol, whatever it may be. And I think that influences a lot of ways of the writing or the processing of what you may write. And as for Ubiquitous itself, I'm trying to create something. I'm basically getting out of the clay of the earth on that part there. I'm just sticking my head out. I'm getting a taste of what's going on, being a little groundhog and stuff. I'm going up, I'm checking things out, and now I want to venture on. And that's going to be the way it is from now on. And me and Trey, we write so much amazing music together, and you know, I'm so happy that he's here, because without Trey actually being here, equipment-wise or anything else, you know, I wouldn't really be anywhere. And two, meeting this person as well as a musician, you know, he brought a lot of things out for me to, you know, to express, and you know, I really thank him for that. And many of the musicians that I've been around, and it's a pleasure for that.
Pretty much laying down groundwork for the EP. Made a song list today of all the songs we've done thus far for the pre-production sessions, and came out to about like 14 songs. So we haven't more than enough material to work with. So just going over that and picking the best ones out of the bunch.
Just got some drum tracks down for one of the songs for a sequel, and it's going pretty good. Sounding pretty good. It's going to be a little bit more mellower. Kind of with the same following of the other song, but we're going to amp it up a little bit. So that's what we're in the process of doing right now.
Sammy, what's going on?
Hey, what's up?
What are we doing today?
We're getting ready to record our reboot track, Candy Cane Part 2, which is part one of something you guys never even heard of, really. But we're going to add an electric part, because originally it's an acoustic song. So right now we're setting up for that.
Listening to like, it's only logical stuff like this, because I mean, they're a little bit heavy, hard beaten kind of songs to them, and the lyrics came out real good. But my favorite is especially No Place Like Home. But for the listeners, I think that's one. We just got back the CD today. Trey went and got the MP3 of the actual song that we did at the studio, and it's not 100% yet. But what is there is sweet. You guys are gonna like it.
Thank you. first part is more or less dealing with the killer, wrapping your mind around the psyche of this killer, and taking you into the steps of what it is that he's going to do to this victim. And the second part is more or less the aftermath.
Are you sure?
Dude, I have no idea what's going on with this shit. Why it even did that?
Because the whole fucking world's against us, dude. I swear to God.
All I need is a random fucking cord. Ah! What the hell happened, dude?
Things were going too good.
Obviously. Get that piece out there and we'll be okay. Got the camera!
Friday, the session that we're about to do, finishing up the second part of Candy Cane Jack, which we were doing before, but we're going to want to add on to it. You can really hear the, it needs it, and so we're going to make a little bit heavier version. You know, I'm hoping, like I said, this is going to be the last one that we recorded for a while, as of prior music, as new music, and with this song, I'm gonna go balls out with it. We're gonna want to end it on a good note, and then once the actual EP comes out, you know, then we'll progress.
Tickets there at the door.
So, Sam,
stand.
I'm very happy bug today. I got new thimbles. It's gonna be a lot better. Got me some nice little 10-inch splash. Some new crashing and a new set of cymbals. So I'm very happy today. This is something that we've been needing for a long time that I was not self-conscious about, but knowing that to get a good quality sound, we have to have these good cymbals. And Right before we shot the last video, I was doing all cool and penetration, baby. That's what happens. But it's okay. I'm a MacGyver, so I turned it upside down. We're gonna use this thing. I know it's not really for that, but you know what? Fuck it.
Guys are just phenomenal. They've also been used by many artists, Ozzy Osbourne, Chris Cornell, Lamb of God, and other ones. So, yeah, these are gonna obviously work out pretty good. And honestly, if there's any drummers watching, I'm gonna have a great cymbal like this just go ahead and check out. And this, these are from Sam Ash. Now, most, a lot of cities don't have them, but here in San Antonio, we do. So that was one great thing that, you know, it's either that or I was going to go pawn shopping. I didn't want to do that today, so. Great sound with these guys, so you'll hear these definitely on the actual CD. So, yeah, we'll see you then.
I'm really excited about that. Trey had ran something by me, and he was following up with our old producer over at 1090 Studios, Jonathan, and he ran into him and talked to him and said, you know, hey, how about we just bring our stuff to your studio and we'll go ahead and do all the drums and everything there professionally, get it done, because Jonathan's got the equipment that we really need, and he's always been a good help to us in the past, so. And it's going to be exciting to go back over there to collaborate again. I'm looking really forward to that. And that's going to be sometime, we're trying to hope, between mid-October to get down there within a three-day span and knock them out. By that time, we can bring them back here to Clamtronic Studios. And we'll bust out the guitar and everything that's the fine-tuning, because we can listen more here. And then after that, it will be ready to be out there for everybody to hear. Buy a copy. Part is the process of making a song. That is, I get so much joy out of progressing from playing something, and then I hear something like, you know what, maybe this could sound like this or this or this, which Jay will describe it, you know, very well. It's, you know, I go back and forth with my music, but with that, I find different things to go along. So if the songs that we've already written, I know later down the line I want to change them or re-alter them, I can do that. Now with this time around.
So much more personality in these recordings than there were in the past.
Thank you.
love playing guitar. Drums is kind of second nature to me. The only sucky part is with our equipment and what we have at the moment, it can't allow me to play drum tracks or write a complete guitar track until we get it perfect. When I say perfect, then I can go back on drums. But I gotta get the right equipment for headgear and stuff because you can't hear it perfectly. Other than that, dude, the songs will come out. I mean, not that I don't now, but I'm pretty good at, if I hear something one time, boom, I can jump on it and go with it. So that's one gift, thank God, that I have. I have that tone just real quick, so that enables me to be able to do so much more within my music.
Honestly, musically wise, I really hope I'm progressed more than what I'm doing right now.
I see myself being a producer. I'm not sure how big of a role that's going to take, I enjoy it. I love recording. You know, it's something I kind of fell into.
Right now is my learning zone. It's letting me build the person that I want to be and who I want to progress as a musician.
I still love writing music, of course. I think I will always write music. I still have a few projects that I'm, pushing to pursue. Honestly, I kind of just see myself sort of doing the same thing I'm doing now, just at a better, at a better position.
The tenure would definitely be on the road and actually producing and doing those type of things, actually learning the stage. Because I've been a big geek when it comes to stage presence. I really like a certain way the stage is set up, lighting, stuff like that. That's the stuff, for me at least, that really brings out the show when you're there.
Actually having my own studio, bringing in bands to record, playing live shows, booking live shows.
You are an entertainer when you are a musician, and for most people, they go there, they don't need the big lights or anything like that, and that's awesome.
I could really go anywhere, do anything I want with it, so that's very exciting for me.
But I'd love to learn way more on that type of stuff, not just for me, but just, future down the road for my bands or whoever, that I can produce that stuff for them and be a part of that.
Well, the way I've always kind of looked at it was, with all of the other projects I do, I have a lot more freedom to roam around and a lot to experiment, which is great to a certain extent, but I feel like after a while you do kind of have to, once you're in that really big headspace, you have to come back down to earth and you have to bring things a little more full circle with the way you write. And Sam really keeps me grounded like that because he usually has a pretty strong idea of what it is that he wants to do. And from there I can just mold it and shape it and turn it into something, very special. And me and Sam have always been able to balance each other out.